children, in today's video we will be discussing about lesson number 4, fractions. So before going for the explanation, get ready with your textbook and pencil and we will start with an activity. So I have a circular paper here and I am going to cut this paper into 4 parts. I am going to cut this paper into 4 parts. That is, I will fold it into half, cut it, and then I fold it again and I'll cut it. So I have kept it ready for you. Here, if I cut it into 4 parts, the 4 parts are here. So how many parts I have here? 4. Now if I take away 1 part of it, so what will this be? It is a 1 part of the 4 parts. It is the 1 part of the 4 parts. So this is fraction. Okay children, this is fraction. I am saying once again, if I take 1 part of the 4, it will be 1 part of the 4. If I take away 2, this will be 2 parts of the 4. If I take away 3, this will be 3 parts of the 4 parts. So this is fraction. Nothing but the part of a whole thing. This is 1 part of a whole circle. So fraction is a part of whole. So definition of fraction is, it is a part of a whole. So in fraction we have different types. We have proper, improper, mess, unit, like and unlike and also equivalent fraction. Before going to the types, now we saw an example using paper. How to write it in a book? How to write it in a book? If I have a 4, I have a circle, I cut it into 4 and I take away 1 part of it. So how will I write that in paper? How will I write it in book? Is how much part I take away, I am going to write it first and then I am going to write a sleeping line and then total part. How many part I have totally is 4. I am going to write it in the denominator, that is down. Down. So what did I write here is 1 by 4, that is 1 part of 4 parts. So if you see here, you have up a number and a number down. So the number up is called numerator. What is number up called? Numerator. And the number down also has a name. It is called denominator. So it is called denominator. So number up, the number which we write up is called numerator. The number which we write down is called denominator. In Germany, we write the number up, that is how many parts we take away, that number we write it up. And the down number will be total number of parts. So this is how we write a number or fraction on book or a paper. Now let us go for types of fractions. So I tell you, first one is proper fraction. First one is proper fraction. What is proper fraction? It is normal. The fraction that we write is called proper fraction. We wrote 1 by 4. Right? This is proper fraction. Now, you will understand the difference between proper and improper now. So, if you see the number up is lesser than the number down. That is, 1 is lesser than 4. Always the number which is on the top should be less. And the number which is on the bottom, that is denominator, should be more. If you write the fraction in this way, this is called proper fraction. If I write it in the opposite way, that is ulta, if I write 8 by 4, 8 is not lesser than 4. So this is called improper fraction. If the numerator is more than the denominator, then it is called improper fraction. Okay, so proper fraction, numerator should be less than the denominator. Improper fraction, numerator will be more than the denominator. Now mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is mixing and writing fraction and a number. identify right 1 and then I write 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 is a fraction and 1 is a number. So if I write both together, it is called mixed fraction. What is unit fraction? So if you see a number here 1 by 4, I have 1 on the numerator, right? So this is called unit fraction. And 1 by 5 is also called unit fraction. 1 by 6 is a unit fraction. So what do you understand? Unit fraction means the numerator should always be 1. Such fractions are called unit fraction. Now like fraction. To explain like fraction, I should take many or so like fraction is a fraction. Two fractions or any number of fractions having the denominators to be same. Denominator means a number which is down. If I have like 2 by 4, 6 by 4, 7 by 4. If you see here, all the denominators are 4, 4, 4, which is same. Such type is called like fraction. Now you yourself can say what is unlike fraction. The denominator should be different. That is called unlike fraction. Like 4 by 5, 6 by 7, 4 by 3. If you see 4 by 3, numerators are same, but denominators are different. So this is called unlike fraction. Now we'll go for equivalent fraction. Till now all the fractions were easy to understand. Now, in equivalent fraction, we have to deal with multiplication also. Let us take a fraction first. 1 by 4. Now, if I multiply this with 2, and I have to multiply numerator also with 2, denominator also with 2. I can't multiply different numbers to numerator and different number to denominator. I have to multiply the same number. So, what is the answer I get? 2 by 8, right? So the number here and the answer here are called equivalent fraction. That is, when you multiply the fraction and you get the answer, both are said to be equivalent fractions. This is simple. We will read it again. Then you will come to one conclusion. You will understand better. So you understood about types of fraction. Now we go for conversion. Conversion means from one form to other. So what form you are going to convert now? Let us see. Now we finished learning about types of fraction. Now we'll go for conversion. Conversion means we are going to change one fraction to other type. We saw so many types, right? We are going to change one type to other type. Mainly we will be changing improper fraction to mixed fraction and mixed fraction back to improper fraction. So how to change it? First let us recall what is improper fraction. Improper fraction is fraction which is not proper. That is, numerator is more, denominator is less. Like this, 8 by 5. Now I have to convert this to mixed fraction. Mixed fraction means number plus fraction, right? We saw mixed fraction is number and fraction together is mixed fraction. So how to convert this? So simple, we will divide it. We will divide 8 and 5. I have 8 and 5. I am going to divide it. Okay, 5 1 log 5. So remainder will be 3. Remainder will be 3. So whatever answer I get, that is my number. That is 1. I'm going to write it first. The answer I get from division is the number, whole number. And the remainder which I get will be my numerator. The remainder which I get will be my numerator. And the number which I took to divide will be my denominator. So denominator here and here same. So I converted the improper fraction to a mixed fraction. I clear here, what did I do? I just divided 8 and 5. What the quotient I got, I wrote it as a number and the remainder I wrote it as numerator and denominator will be the same. So So I converted from improper to mixed. Now you are here to convert from improper to mixed. How to come back? How to convert mixed to improper? That is also simple. To convert from improper to mixed, we divided. So to convert from mixed to improper, you're gonna multiply. How to multiply? I am going to write a symbol. Let me take the same number which I have got the answer here, and I'll show you. I'll get back to improper fraction. 1, 3 by 5. What I will do is I'll multiply here and add here. That is, I'll multiply this two numbers. Whatever answer I get, I'll add it with the numerator. So 5 1 the 5 1 the 5 1 the 5. Whatever answer I get, I should add it with numerator. So plus 3. What is the answer I got? 8. I got the answer 8. So I write the answer in my numerator and denominator is the same. So if you see, I got the improper fraction back. This is how I convert mixed fraction to improper fraction. So you are clear with. Now we will see reduction. So what do you mean by reduction is, if I have a fraction, like any fraction, let it be an improper or proper fraction, I am going to divide and get it to a smaller number. I divide both numerator and denominator with the same number. If I take 2 and 2, I can divide both with 2, so I am taking 2 here. So I divide 8 with 2, what is the answer I get? I get 4. And I divide 4 with 2, what is the answer I get? 2. So now I have reduced 8 by 4 to 4 by 2. So this is called reduction. Can I reduce 4 by 2? Yes, I can reduce, because 4 by 2 again can be divided with 2 and 2. So if I divide 4 by 2, I get 2. I divide 2 by 2, I get 1. So the smallest number is the reduction number. I can reduce 8 by 4 to 2 by 1. Okay? First I reduce 8 by 4 to 4 by 2, and then again I reduce 4 by 2 to 2 by 1 by dividing it by 2. So this is called reduction. So now let us go for page number 126. 126, exercise 4.1. So what is the first thing? What fraction of each shape is shaded? So you have to write it in fraction type. So what is the first one? They have a circle. How many parts are shaded? 3 parts are shaded. And totally how many parts you have? Shaded and unshaded. Totally how many you have? It is 4. So the first thing, first answer, exercise 4.1. So the first answer is 3 by 4. The number of shaded part is 3 and total number of parts is 4. So the answer is 3 by 4. Let us go for the second one now. If you see, there is a triangle. And how many parts are there? Totally just 2 parts. And how many parts are shaded? 1 part. So how will you write it in fraction type? You should write it as 1. That is number of parts shaded divided by total number of parts, 1 by 2. The answer for second is 1 by 2. Can you answer the third one? I'll ask you this question in the interactive session. You will try the third one out. Now we'll go for second main. Second main, page number 127. In second main, the question is circle the proper fraction. What does it mean by proper fraction? Proper fraction means the number which is on the top, that is numerator. Second name, 4.1.
In 6th grade,
take the question multiplying with 3. What is the answer I get? 9 by 15. So this is my equivalent fraction. This is also equivalent fraction. So I found out 2 equivalent fractions. This is the first one. So I'll open up again the C one for you. 7 by 8. So first I'll multiply this with 2. I get 14 by 16. Next I'll multiply this with 3. I get 21 by 24. So these two are my equivalent fractions I got. Clear? Now let us go for the next name. Convert into mixed fraction. So converting, we saw converting into mixed means from improper to mixed. So what should we do? We should divide. So let us convert the numbers.
Okay, children, now let me show you one more example that is
11 tables. I can divide both numbers with 11 tables. So I get 4 by 5. This is the smallest form. Are you clear with this? So in this video we learn type, what is fraction, types of fractions, conversion, reduction, everything, and we did the exercise sums. Whichever we have to do it in textbook, please complete your textbook. I'm going to check it in the interactive session. And then which you're going to work it out in the classwork, you try it out in your classwork before you get the notes. I'll send the notes in mail. So thank you.